Japan really on a tear right now. And we're seeing some data now confirming what a lot of us felt anecdotally, but the data now showing that yes, Japan is one of the hottest travel destinations in the world right now. And this is despite the fact that Japan opened rather late, even by Asia Pacific terms. We saw incoming travelers surpass pre-pandemic levels back in October, then again in December, and now in February, arrivals up 7% compared to 2019. And this is without the benefit of Japan's largest source market, which is Chinese travelers. Now, Japan recovering quite well, and this is because so many other people are wanting to go there. In fact, if we look to Visa's 2023 survey, we can see among Asia Pacific travelers, about one in four said that they took a leisure trip to Japan. That's ahead of 17% who went to Australia, 11% to Singapore, and 9% to Thailand. But if we go broader than this, if we look to Visa's global survey, which polled about 37,000 travelers, we still see Japan coming out on top, ahead of Australia, France, and the United States. Now, if we core into exactly who is going, we can see a lot of Japan's neighbors still going, such as South Korea and Taiwan, but even bigger growth rates coming in from Southeast Asia. Places like Indonesia up 55%, Malaysia 64%, and the Philippines 85%. But even from places much farther away, we can still see a lot more travelers heading into Japan, up 61% from the United States. And look at this, 167% from Mexico. Now, as of last week, Visa now saying that Singaporeans say they prefer Japan even over Malaysia for leisure trips. Now this, when we look into why, we see it's for many of the same reasons that others say that they go to Japan. And it, in fact, a lot of the reasons people travel in general. It's because it sort of ticks the box for all types of travelers. People are going to relax, for history, for culture, for shopping, and of course the food. Japan also perceived as being clean and safe, which are two big issues for travelers since the pandemic.
Is it really just all about the weaker yen as well?
That is a major draw, because people think right now, well, if I can get in, why wait to go next year if it's going to be cheaper this year? And interestingly, because of the rise of people going, it's actually making the cost going up. So hotels now said to be about 25% more expensive. So if you are going to chase the discount because of the exchange rate, there is something to be said for that, but prices are going up. But there are a lot of first-time travelers. Japan's always been the type of country that would attract a lot of people to go for the first time. And because of that, we published a story this morning on CNBC.com where we asked very frequent travelers to Japan, a lot of people that used to actually live there, and we said, look, give us your single best piece of advice. And we got great information about where to eat, what not to eat, how to meet people, and the punctuality required to board a train. I almost made that mistake myself one time. But probably my favorite tip came from the author of that piece, and he wrote about Meishi. It's a business cards in Japan. He gets them made as a traveler, and he exchanges them with people. And he said it's a great icebreaker and potentially even a way to keep in touch with people.
And take your phrase book along as well, because the first time I went to Japan, I was speaking a smattering of Japanese, and it just really made the trip very memorable.